Dave, you know? How we do it? That's not good, Melvin. Don't want that. There you go, we'll do live chat so we know who's saying what, don't we? Ooh, that's a good song. It's always the way, ain't it? Mates, evening, Jacob. Your mates are always on Spotify when you don't want them to be. Jacob, I'll let you spam me link tonight. If you're feeling generous. I'm always calm, me. Bit on. TFI Friday. Find it of their own accord. Okay, your control rate working now. Nothing's working. Great. Don't do this to me. No. What's a better controller plugged into the wrong port? I just love it when things, you know, absolutely positively don't go to plan. Yeah, it is the correct controller I normally use. For some strange reason, Forza is not playing ball. Ah, it is now. Well, weird. Yes, he's going to be a single player for tonight. Purely because their servers are foobar at the minute. Well, if people want to try and run a convoy, then we can try, but... tell if that's I don't know. I don't know what title it is I got. Toy boat is a toy boater. Don't ask me what card's starting because the youngest was playing it the other day. Photo challenge. Rally monster at the quarry. Well, that's not hard, is it?
Welcome back, James.
Yes, okay. Evening, Panda. Cheers, Jacob. There's the above. Ooh. That's one way of doing it, MTB. Alright, let's... What we got? Let's just... Alright, let's have a look at the quarry. Where's the quarry? There's the quarry. That'll be. That ain't too bad. Yeah. It's already messed up because it's not... While we wait for that, I'm gonna... Got to get him a proper car, ain't I? Trying to see how many miles I've done in this, but I can't tell.
Turn left.
Drive on the left in this country, don't we? Ooh. Found me a session, did it? That road sign makes no sense. Oh, I always do photo challenges because they're easy and you might get something decent out of it. You never know. Yeah. Safe to say that Forza servers are still messed up.
Turn right.
Been connected for, what, 20 seconds then?
Turn right.
And it dropped me straight away.
Turn left.
Hi, Juku.
In 400 yards, turn left.
Exactly, Jacob. Yeah, a funny feeling that MP would just be a complete washout tonight.
Turn right.
Oops. Let's see if we can... How do I go solo? There we go. Ah, did it, Ma. That ain't too bad, Panda, you.
Turn right. Turn right.
Nope. Go straight.
Yards.
Yeehaw.
Turn right. In 100 yards, turn left.
Go on, roll it. Bam.
You have arrived at your destination.
Oh, I need a rally monster dome. Ugh, I'm a fish. Forgot that one. Change car. Filter. Rally monster. There we go. What we got? Ooh, not good.
Rally monster.
Dong 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 dong. There we go. Photo challenge done. There we go. Shared. It's double T. Audi Quattro. See? Quattro. Oh, what else can we do? Super Wall Smith first. That would have done nicely. 160 grand, 150 grand, and a new Beamer. McLaren. Oh. One out of three ain't too bad, is it? McLaren 570. What else have we got? Iron Driver, formidable night. Well, that's not hard, is it? I don't think I own that car, though. Let's have a look. No, I don't want to access the desktop. Mercedes. Nope, I don't own it. Me not own it. No. What else can we do? Online adventure. Yeah, we'll try that. Let's go some free for all. It's more fun. Oops. Maybe not. Is it Jacob?
River on.
Yeah, if this says so. Yeah, whatever. Hey. Oh, I've got an all-wheel drive. Come on, Jacob, you know me. My brain doesn't work best of times, let alone now. Yeah, not bad, Dalton. What do you mean if it works, Jacob? Computer said now. Nope, didn't work. Alright, let's find some races I haven't done, shall we? What are you? I'm trying to find some new fun races to do. Skills Freak? Nah. Let's go have a look at Top Gear. It's probably DLC, but hey ho. Yes, I've got traction control.
In 400 yards,
I'm not that good.
Turn left. Turn left.
Can't drive this. Bag of bombs. Give me my Subaru. Anything, just Subaru. There goes JCB Monkey. Recognise him. No, it's not actually proper races, is it? It's just avatars. Lambo ain't the best.
In 400 yards.
Out for a mother's meet, you know what?
Turn right. In 200 yards, turn left.
Lambos are overrated.
Turn left.
Scooby. Scooby dooby dooby dooby! Doo 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 doo. Oh yeah, in real life I'd love a Volvo, because oops.
You have arrived at your destination.
Ooh, changing seasons. If only we could do that in real life.
Tonight, the Stig drives some very fast farm equipment, I hail a taxi, and finishing with something that I'm reliably informed is a bit of a fan favourite around here.
Pilatus.
I'm Chris Harris, and this is the Top Gear Horizon Special. Ah yes, the Stig, our very own UFO. Unidentified fast object, the world's least obedient racing driver.
Gotta stay above 90.
Right then, the Lotus Elise, a 90s classic based on the age-old Roadster recipe. Two seats, engine in the middle, rear-wheel drive. Not an ounce of fat. This is what driving is all about.
Yes, at least you can drop below 90.
The honourable art of drifting.
Drifting, no way. Go over the dam. If I see the dam, I'll go over it. I don't.
But this isn't just any Elise. It's a Sport 190, a tuned-up, stripped-out Elise for track days. Even the passenger seat is an optional extra. But who needs friends anyway? Friends are expensive.
Go on, get back to 90 from that. Thank you very much.
A serious slide there. Loving your work, Stiggy. Oops. Happens to the best of us. One more go should do it. I'm Chris Harris, and this is the Top Gear Horizon Special. Ah yes, the Stig, our very own UFO. Unidentified fast object, the world's least obedient racing driver.
What? That's basically a river, and the Elise definitely doesn't have a snorkel.
Right, now which way am I going? It? Just guess.
The Honourable Art of Drifting.
The festival.
All right, it's not the fastest way around a corner, but it's definitely the most entertaining.
Well, I'm going this way now, ain't I? So I've got to spin it round. Ugh. That ain't gonna keep me at 90, is it?
One more run, I reckon. We'll get it next
time. I do agree that old Top Gear was the best.
I'm Chris Harris, and this is
right, so let's go over the dam and turn left. Let's try again, shall we?
Ah yes, the Stig, our very own UFO, unidentified fast.
Ah yes,
object,
so it is.
The world's
My
least
bad.
Obedient racing driver. Basically a river, and the Elise definitely doesn't have a snorkel or a life jacket. You've got it. The trick with drifting is to not actually spin, but to almost spin for as long as possible.
Why is it not giving me a new route?
Yes, that's it. The Honourable Art of Drifting. It's not the fastest way around a corner, but it's definitely the most entertaining. Take as long as you like. I've got nothing else to do. I'm Chris Harris, and this is the Top Gear Horizon Special.
Alright, sorry. It's...
Ah yes, the Stig.
This
our
break.
Very own UFO. Unidentified fast object. The world's least obedient racing driver.
Left first, right, and then left.
That's basically a river, and the Elise definitely doesn't have a snorkel or a life jacket. Completely sideways now, making it look easy too.
Completely. I wish we could mute him, because he sounds rather annoying. Sounds good, definitely. Excuse me, coming through.
A serious slide there. Bring it back around. Let's have another crack at this.
You're going to see me a rage quit in
I'm
a second.
I'm Chris Harris, and this is the Top Gear Horizon Special.
I don't care who you are, I don't care what this is, just let me do this.
Fast object, the world's least obedient racing driver.
Right, this is lots of crashes.
Right, it's not the fastest way around a corner, but it's definitely the most entertaining. That's basically a river, and the Elise definitely doesn't have a snorkel or a life jacket.
I'm going to stop trying to drift that bend, and I'm just going to, you know, drive it normal. So obviously, drifting ain't working for me. Or I can just do that. Try again. Yeah, we'll try again, shall we?
Yes, yes, I know this is all very good fun, but we really need to nail this bit. I'm Chris Harris, and this is the Top Gear Horizon Special.
Yes, I know who you are, and I know what this is.
Ah, yes, the Stig, our very own UFO, unidentified fast object, the world's least...
Trust me, I ain't that fast.
Driver.
Do,
the Elise definitely doesn't have a snorkel or a life jacket.
Be a Peugeot driver.
It's not the fastest way around a corner, but it's definitely the most entertaining.
Alright, don't cut the corner, don't drift the corner. Round of applause, please. I made it. Alright, and then it's a left.
Yes! That's it! The honourable art of drifting. Whoops! Happens to the best of us. One more go should do it.
I didn't commit to the bend.
I'm Chris Harris, and this is the Top Gear Horizon.
Alright, at least now I know where I'm going and what I'm doing.
Yes, the Stig, our very own UFO, unidentified fast object, the world's least obedient racing driver. That's basically a river, and the Elise definitely doesn't have a snorkel or a life jacket.
Doesn't help that you got the voiceover crap saying stuff that's totally irrelevant. And it confuses me. I'm just a simple farmer.
Alright, it's not the fastest way around a corner, but it's definitely the most entertaining. The honourable art of drifting.
Oh, pig off.
Well, they did say to use the fastest route possible, and if there's one thing faster than a racing line, it's a straight line. You've got to hand it to the Stig. Made it! Was there ever any doubt? The Series 1 Elise is, after all, one of the best-handling cars ever made. The Sport 190 is its hardest cousin, a road
racer
you can drive to work and across fields, it turns out. But if it's true agricultural transport you're after, we have just the thing. A serious slide there. Loving your work, Stiggy.
So it's totally irrelevant what he's saying. Sounds like a complete plum as well. Yes, you helped. Thank you, Jacob. Tonight on Top Gear, punch ourselves in the face. Yeah, because everybody wants that. Ha. Something along them lines, MTB. Just not as friendly as that. Well, while we're here, we might as well continue the story. And see if we can get myself a track. I ain't got a brand new combine harvester, and I'll give you the key.
Ooh, a BMW 1M. Great car. Hang on, that's my BMW 1M.
He's a German engineer. Go!
Seriously? Not funny. Who gave Stig the keys?
Me. Park at the destination without exceeding the damage limit. Well, crumble 84.
I mean, I literally just cleaned it. Now it's going to smell of onions. Odor Stig. Well, this isn't stressful to watch. Not at all.
Turn right. In 200 yards, turn left.
If Jacob can remember it, I'll let him type it in the chat for me. Oops. Oops. Big oops. Oh, God, I barely scratched it. 4 miles and over half damage.
That's the last time we leave Stig unattended. Am I the only one who remembers Budapest?
It depends if Budapest was in the old...
It's electronically restrained to 155 miles an hour, but it could definitely go quicker. It's a BMW, so of course it's rear-wheel drive. 50-50 weight distribution too. It's a natural-born drifter.
It's an actual dung heap. It's just my personal opinion.
Does 0 to 60 in 4.8 seconds, my 1M. Stig's way beyond that now.
In 200 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Oh, behave, it was a road time, not even that much damage. Cheated. Yeah, 1.7 miles to total it. Result.
One of the best BMWs ever made, this, born to be driven by me. Got to admit though, Stig does kind of suit it.
At the roundabout, take the second exit.
3 litre straight six, 335 horsepower, two turbos, as much sideways action as you like.
Bit too fast into the roundabout, weren't I? Never mind. It's nearly completely written off. Oh, new club.
Almost there now. Oh, what a shame. I was really getting into that. Just park it up now, Stig, and mind the curbs. Now, anyone else want to go? No? Don't say anything. Ask.
I parked. Don't know how well I did.
Right. Back to the actual script now, if you don't mind. This is Top Gear's Tractor. It's a tractor, obviously, but with a 5.7-litre Chevy V8 making 500 horsepower. And here comes the Stig again. Farm Stig. Born in a barn, they say, weaned by pigs, can plough a field in under 6 seconds.
Anybody can plough a field in under 6 seconds with a bit of dynamite.
There's a speed camera on the M68. Rumour has it, it only flashes above 87.2 miles an hour. Our tractor has been officially clocked at 87.2 miles an hour, making it the world's fastest tractor.
But I was going to say that is actually a Ultra. 136. Excuse me, coming through. You're a plum. Go, Sticky, go, go, go. Ah, yeah, they did do a, JCB. It was voucher for a while, weren't it?
Those are 54-inch mud tyres, remember? They get a bit squishy through the corners. Nobody needs to get the harvest in that quickly.
Remember that? That was a good bit of driving, wasn't it? Excuse me, going through.
Right, here comes the speed camera. Hope they put some film in it. Oh! Have you ever seen anything like it? That's a new tractor speed record and some impressively fast farming. If you want to spread slurry in a hurry, you know what you need. Now, though, it's time to hail a ride in something completely different.
I probably could have gone a bit better, a little bit faster, but I'm hitting that car. Oh, so close to 171. Ooh, new car. Life is like a box of chocolates. Achoo, my finger slipped. Daito is too easy, Melwin. It took me God knows how long to do the first challenge.
I called a cab earlier. Local company, Aisha's Taxis. Excellent service. Got me here in no time. Unsurprising, really. I mean, look at what turned up. Hands down, the quickest cab I've ever been in. Which got me thinking, how fast could this thing actually go?
Oh, great. Drag racing a taxi, are we?
So I had a word with Aisha. Asked if we could borrow her cab for a trip to the seaside. To Bamborough Beach, in fact, where we could stretch the taxi's legs a bit. Although, I might have forgotten to tell her who'd be driving. You've guessed it. The cabbie who'll always get you to your destination very early, but probably won't be anywhere near where you asked to go. Those tires must be worn now. Surprised they're still in one piece, to be honest. Oh, yes. Spot on. Lightning reactions, quick hands.
I'll try not to, Feefly. But this is me,
now,
so guaranteed.
What I call a cab. No clattery diesel engine here. This has a V12 with over 750 horsepower, plus bucket seats. Beaded bucket seats, presumably.
Yeah, it's safe to say I can't see diddly squat.
Think about it. More stability, more speed, more downforce, more room for your terrified passengers.
V12 taxi that I can't drive.
In 400 yards,
crash.
It even has slick tyres for maximum grip on a bone-dry drag strip, so they should be interesting when we hit the beach.
It was definitely 400 yards crash, wasn't it? That's what she said. Yay, we lived. Sort of. She could do the same in a real car, ain't it?
In 400 yards, turn left.
400 yards crash again, okay. I can do that.
Turn left.
Don't think anybody's ever going to get in a taxi with me,
yards.
Are they?
Turn left.
Is that a handbrake? Give it a puddle. Give it a wash.
Turn left.
There we go.
Right.
Bit beat up, but hey ho. Be fine.
Turn right.
Yeah, take out the gate.
Turn left.
Straight line.
Good work from the stick there.
Okay.
I'd say we're nicely warmed up for the next.
They don't look like slick tyres to me.
So here we are then. In the old days, daredevils used smooth, sandy beaches like this to see how fast their cars could go. Many early land speed records were set on beaches. Miles of space, nothing to hit. Sounds easy, right?
This is me. Come on, hit a house.
Oh, look at that! Laying some pretty squirmy tracks there, Stiggy. That's what happens with 750 horsepower on sand. But that's the challenge here. Go as fast as possible all the way to the top of the beach.
Bonjour, bonjour, Adam.
Something I haven't told the stick. Speed record rules say you must do two runs, one in each direction, before the clock runs out. Which means, Stiggy, pulling off the world's swiftest U-turn, which of course is when the handbrake comes in handy.
There you go. I use the brakes. And that's B-R-A-K-E-S, not brake as in... Yeah. Just thought I'd correct your spelling there, Jacob.
A 5-star ride from the Stig there. Minicab, maximum speed. Next time I need a ride to the airport, I know who I'm calling. And all of this off-road action has given me an idea.
Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah, so I just won Mercedes E350D. I think he does, Adam. Achoo. As we're doing so well, no point breaking a winning streak of stuff, is there?
This is Project EAT. That's EAT for E-Class All Terrain. It's a modified Merc built by the Top Gear magazine team for finding bears in the woods. Not many bears around here, though. Mostly badgers. Still, there's definitely some terrain. Lots of it. All you need is a good sense of direction. Or not. Here's Stig again, looking lost. Terrified of maps, apparently. Inner compass points directly south.
Right, so where have we got to go?
The EAT has a silky smooth V6 diesel. It'll do 155 miles an hour on the road, but where we're going, we won't need roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rannoch by any means necessary and against the clock, naturally. But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres.
In 400 yards, turn left. Turn left. Calculating route.
There we go. Avoid Edinburgh.
That's a four-wheel drive car on mud tyres completely sideways. You'd do well in rallying with skills like that. Top draw drifting, I reckon.
I do well at rallying anyway. Just...
Who says you need an SUV to go off-road? The EAT has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps.
Wasn't for all the toxic trees, just straight line it.
Ancient burial mounds, for example.
But the toxic trees are in the way.
That's some proper hang time. Actual air suspension.
In 400 yards... Turn left.
Smegging trees.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
I don't need to turn.
Well, it is a Mercedes wagon, so it's tough. And if you really want to smash stuff up, there's even a pickaxe in the back.
No, I don't need a pickaxe. Excuse me, coming through. Gangway.
200 yards. Turn right.
It also has 340 horsepower, more torque than a cruise ship, and gets to 60 miles an hour in just over 5 seconds.
But can it do this? Ha! Is this avoiding Edinburgh enough?
Time to head way over there, to the very top of Arthur's Seat. But first, what goes up must come down.
Okay.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
No, I don't want to turn around. I'm going this way. See?
Recalculating route.
Why give me an off-roader? I can't take it off-road.
In 200 yards, Turn right.
Oops. No idea where I'm going. Down the hill, out of there. Whee! Boy.
Turn around when it is safe to do so. In 200
bit
yards,
dark.
Turn left.
It's full of home comforts, the EAT. Charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting. Even a portable espresso machine. Everything
I've got a bit
fixated
on that tree, though.
Ever need.
Goodness. Bet I'm heading straight for Edinburgh, aren't I?
Recalculating route.
Go this way. Keep turning a bit too early then.
At the roundabout, take the first exit.
I don't think I'm gonna finish it in time for a gold star.
All this adventure kit's had a tiny effect on the fuel efficiency. Good job the roof rack holds 2 cans of diesel, and there's another one in the back. Just don't confuse them with your drinking water.
Recalculating route.
Recalculating route. It's over there somewhere. It's amazing, that isn't it? Somewhere out there. We're driving from Edinburgh.
At the roundabout,
this way.
Take the first exit.
On to the final stretch now. Just the small matter of getting up Arthur's seat. The clock's ticking, so better step on it, Stiggy.
In 200 yards, turn left. In 200 yards, turn left.
One star. Shocking. Pitiful.
And there we go. The top of Arthur's seat. No idea who Arthur is, by the way, or why his seat's so big. Nice view, though.
Emails, no stick around. Oh, I need a drink. 250. Yeah. Good evening, Ollie.
Driving some British classics, and you don't get more British than a car built in Birmingham designed by a man from Greece. Anyway, here it is, an original Mini Cooper S, an icon of 60s engineering.
Always wanted one of these cars.
Cities, but this is the wide body one, so we're going to need a bit more room, and I know just the place. Ready, Stig?
Always wanted one of these.
The Mini is cleverly packaged, capable of carrying 4 people and their luggage. Hand luggage, presumably.
It's a super fast roller skate.
Mm.
It is, it's the world's fastest roadster. Get in. Trees! Only a bit broken.
The Cooper S was the car to beat on the famous Monte Carlo rally. It pretty much wiped the floor with the competition.
At the roundabout.
At the roundabout, take a shortcut.
The Cooper S was developed by a bloke called John Cooper, who also built F1 cars, so it had real racing pedigree.
There we go. Oh. Get out of the way. Slow people.
And it wasn't just Monte Carlo either. The British Saloon Car Championship, the Thousand Lakes Rally, even the Australian Touring Car Championship. Almost any time the Mini turned up, it won.
Turn left.
Excuse me, Mr. Bimbley.
In 400 yards, turn right.
400 yards?
Turn right.
Okay.
And here we are.
Yeah.
Told you it was spacious.
I'd be a bit scared about going 18 mile an hour in one of them.
We've got especially everything the way here: an airfield, the original rapid runabout, and the Stig. I'm looking forward to this.
Oh great! What have I got to do now?
Look at that, laying down some rubber there.
Beat the skills target.
Has much to lay. After all, tiny wheels mean tiny tyres. This little Mini punches well above its weight. It's literally unstoppable. Forget rallying, this thing was made for demolition derbies.
Hey!
They sold nearly 5.5 million Minis. But only this one could fly, apparently.
Ah, bro, I can fly.
Lovely work there. Short wheelbase, front wheel drive. It's really not an easy car to slide, this.
Telling me it's not.
It might be Mini on the outside, but it's Maxi on the inside. Wanna guess the world record for the most people crammed inside one? I'll tell you, it's 27. Gymnasts. No idea if they all came out in one piece.
I've got one star at least. A few donuts to finish it off.
All right, someone tell the Stig we're done now. It's time for a spot of sightseeing.
110,000. I don't know how anybody gets free stops. I want to get the tractor.
Skill. Nerve. Cutting-edge performance vehicles. Oh, and bricks. Lots and lots and lots of Lego bricks. We've teamed up with Lego to create the biggest event Horizon has ever assembled.
I don't care. Just...
It's time for Lego Speed Champions.
Right, so if I go... I don't want to do all of that again, do I? I suppose. Where's the beach from there? We'll try it again, see if we can get 3 stars.
Now, I said we'd be driving some British classics. And you don't get more British than a car built in Birmingham designed by a man from...
Greece.
Anyway, here it is, an original Mini Cooper S, an icon of 60s engineering. It was designed for cities, but this is the wide-body one, so we're going to need a bit more room. And I know just the place. Ready, Stig?
Yes, we know. Go. Ready. Beep, beep.
The Mini is cleverly packaged, capable of carrying 4 people and their luggage. Hand luggage, presumably.
Yeah, you'd have to direct me to the beach from there, Jacob. Too much speed in the road.
Was the car to beat on the famous Monte Carlo rally. It pretty much wiped the floor with the competition.
Beep beep.
At the roundabout, take the shortcut exit.
The Cooper S was developed by a bloke called John Cooper, who also built F1 cars, so it had real racing pedigree. And it wasn't just Monte Carlo either. The British Saloon Car Championship, the Thousand Lakes Rally, even the Australian Touring Car Championship. Almost any time the Mini turned up, it won.
Turn left. In 400 yards, turn right. Turn right.
And here we are. Told you it was spacious.
Oh, BRB peeps. Got to go and sort the eldest out. She's messing about and won't get to
the original rapid runabout and the stick.
So I'll be right back.
Looking forward to this.
Oh, I need to find out if I can pause this first time. Probably not.
Look at...
Yeah, I don't care about that. No, just go straight. Right, I'll just do that.
Bam, laying down some rubber there. Not that it has much to lay. After all, tiny wheels mean tiny tyres.
Yeah, straight line. There we go, happy nose of fun.
Whee! Now that's just showing off. What is it with minis and shipping containers?
All right, I can't go proper straight line, can I? There's a farm there.
This little Mini punches well above its weight. It's literally unstoppable. Forget rallying, this thing was made for demolition derbies. They sold nearly 5.5 million Minis. But only this one could fly, apparently.
Have all that can fly. Woo! Have all that can touch the sky. I made it down to the boot over. Rubber driver, fast over. Dee 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 dee. Dee 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 dee. This won't run out of feet, isn't it?
Yep.
Snag! Oh, at least I didn't lose all them points. That would have been atrocious, wouldn't it? I'll keep the point. Finish this event and then I need to go and sort out the eldest AKA Saint by the sound of it. Gosh, what? Drag strip! Ready, ready, go! Oh, 70, can get 180.
Oh. Alright, someone tell us that we're done now. It's time for sightseeing. 106
pounds. I think that was even worse than last time. But it should give me the tractor. I don't care about this, just let me know if I've got the tractor and then I can go and shout at the eldest. Ah! That was nap, wasn't it? Right. BRB peeps. Dooms. I remember that. I am back. I want to get me the tractor and then I'm going to stop doing Top Gear stuff. As Chris Harris is annoying me. Sounds good, don't it?
Here we are then, Edinburgh. Where it's time
can
for
we
a
not
spot
skip
of turbocharged
this?
Tourism with this, the mighty Porsche GT2 RS. All we need now is our tour guide. Stig, the world's worst Scotsman, allergic to tartan, absolutely petrified of bagpipes, or so I've heard. Right, let's see if we can visit every bell tower in Edinburgh and get back here before they all stop ringing.
In 400 yards, turn left. Turn left.
What a car this is. 3.8 litre flat six, two turbos, 700 horsepower, all wrapped up in carbon fibre with wings, stripes, holes and vents for snorting in the air.
At the roundabout, take the first exit.
Nippy little thing, isn't it? 0 to 60 takes 2.7 seconds. Just the job for a bit of speedy sightseeing.
Yeah, you get to overtake the glitter on a bend. Bounce off the wall.
In 400 yards,
it doesn't help, it doesn't actually tell you which way you need to go until you get to it.
It might be street legal, but it's only a pair of fireproof underpants away from being a full-blown racing car.
200 yards, turn right.
Excuse me, taxi boy.
Turn right.
Move, taxi boy, move! Oh, it's bigger than me.
Take the second exit.
It's a real masterpiece of engineering, this GT2 RS. The wheels are made from magnesium, the exhaust is titanium.
It's just exotic, just slammed into the walls for the fun of it.
I love it!
Turn left. 200 yards. Turn sharp
right.
How's
that turning left?
Excellent hooliganry. That's what 700 horsepower and rear-wheel drive will do for you if you have the guts for it. And an effective laundry detergent.
How many more? Christ.
It's limited to 211 miles an hour. Faster, and it would need special tyres. But with the stick behind the wheel, who knows? Ooh, inch perfect there. It's wider than a regular 911, this GT2, and about 20 times more terrifying. Basically, the perfect device for nipping in and out of city traffic.
Excuse me, Mr. Gritter. Come on, we can do it.
200 yards, turn right, turn right.
Well, that was the last one then, I got all excited. 25 seconds. Ooh. It's gonna be close.
At the roundabout, take the first exit.
Into the final stretch now. Note to stick, remember to park properly at the end. And watch out for traffic wardens.
Well, I ain't going to do 3 stars, am I? No. 2 stars, though. Ooh, that was close.
Good work. Hard on those carbon ceramic brakes now. They can stop a locomotive dead in its tracks.
Anyway, parked. Yay! Yay, Crumbo. Ah, does it, Ma? Give me some XP so I can get me tractor. Yeah. I'm happy now. I've got my tractor. How many have we done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm tempted to say we just do all of them because there's only 10, isn't there? Get it all done and dusted out of the way.
Oh, I told you we'd finish with a fan's favourite, and here it is. No, not the lorry, the thing on the back under the tarp. You'll love it. But first, we need to move it into position. Thankfully, we have our very own haulage expert, a trucker's trucker. No load too large. Yes, it's Big Rig Stig.
Oh, great.
Right, now take it easy, Stig. That's some expensive cargo you have back there. Costs as much as a house. Weighs about the same, too.
Right, so we've got half a Scania cab. Oh yeah, the side profile of the Scania cab. And we've got the front end of a Iveco.
Worked out what it is yet? Okay, here are some cryptic clues. It's all-wheel drive, but not four-wheel drive. It's a wagon, but you definitely don't need a horse to pull it.
I'm saying it's a G-Wagon, ain't it?
In 200 yards,
the six wheel
turn left.
Blob.
Turn left.
Excuse me! Oh my god, this turn's worse than a house. Oh. Technically, this shouldn't do a handbrake turn either, but we'll try and find out, shall we? Race to the destination! At 40 miles an hour. Speed camera. Yeah, something matters in this, don't it? We hit the limiter. Okay, we've put the limiter.
That's 5 tons of flatbed carrying 4 tons on its back. Don't you just hate getting stuck behind a slow, lumbering old... Wait a minute. It's actually accelerating. Up a hill. I guess that's what 9 foot...
Well, this truck will weigh more than 5 tons.
That plus trucker Stig.
Somewhere I used to work at 18 tonners and they could only carry 9, so, you know, work it out.
Almost there. Just park it up and we'll whip those covers off.
Oh, you can't go in cab, you? That's enough.
Good job, Big Rig Stig. Suits you, you know. Although, come to think of it, maybe pick up some more your style. Especially the one we have in store.
Mercedes-Benz six-wheel drive. Bet you any money. What do we reckon?
Oh. I give you the Mercedes G63 AMG 6x6. It's the ultimate off-roader, a 4-ton, six-wheel sports utility truck. Basically, a G-Wagon with the back half of a pickup thrown in for free.
All right, and what we're going to do
up
in this
front
heat
is a 5.5-litre twin-turbo V8. Usually it's limited to 100 miles an hour, but not this one.
In 100 yards, turn right.
Oh, someone call air traffic control. I'm pretty sure you need a special license to fly one of these.
We're just driving around the off-road course, are we?
With all of the wheels comes all of the grip. The 6x6 turns mountains into motorways.
Oh, yeah, that's really impressive. Quite a slight way, isn't it?
Yards. Turn left.
Do we get this car at some point? I hope so. I'll take it and slam it into a track.
400 yards. Turn left.
Imagine one of these advancing. Okay. Plow it.
Turn left.
It makes 536 horsepower and more than 760 newton meters of torque. With that speed limiter removed, and with the stick behind the wheel, it'll do 125 miles an hour, with a bit of a run-up. It's tough, the 6x6. After all, it was originally made for the Australian Army. It's basically a tank.
with heated seats.
In 200 yards, turn left.
It can wade through a meter of water, this thing. Most cars need full scuba kit at that depth. Ridiculous.
In 200 yards, turn
left.
So
people going to do 3 stars again, aren't we?
Turn left.
Top job there, Stig. Take them all. No idea what Stig does with them. Goat yoga.
That was close.
Anyway, I've been Chris Harrison, still am, and this has been the Top Gear Horizon special. Thanks for coming. Now, let's go see what this Forzathon live thing's all about.
Was that it? Come on, give me a decent car. 170 grand, yeah, that was. Hold on. Oh. I got to the end.
This is Project EAT. That's EAT for E-Class All Terrain. It's a modified Merc built by the Top Gear magazine team for finding bears in the woods. Not many bears around here, though. Mostly badgers. Still, there's definitely some terrain. Lots of it. All you need is a good sense of direction. Or not. Here's Stig again, looking lost. Terrified of maps, apparently.
Go on, Jake.
Inner compass points directly south.
Straight line.
The EAT has a silky smooth V6 diesel. It'll do 155 miles an hour on the road, but where we're going, we
go
around roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rannoch by any means necessary.
Right. If I pause it, does it pause the time?
But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres.
That's what I need to know.
400 yards.
So I can plan a different
turn
route.
Left. Turn left. Recalculating route.
Well, it is a Mercedes wagon, so it's tough. And if you really want to smash stuff up, there's even a pickaxe in the back.
Be careful going down and then blow it over. Can't really straight line it down
for
3,
can you? Who says you need an SUV to go off-road? The EAT has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps and everyday obstacles. Ancient burial mounds, for example.
In 400 yards, turn left.
That's some proper hang time. Actual air suspension.
Calculating route. Turn around when it is safe to do so.
It also has 340 horsepower, more torque than a cruise ship, and gets to 60 miles an hour in just over 5 seconds.
In 400 yards, turn right.
Don't crash your plug.
To head way over there to the very top of Arthur's Seat. But first, what goes up must come down.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Hopefully he's going up it yet.
Recalculating route. In 400 yards, turn right.
That's a four-wheel drive car on mud tyres, completely sideways. You'd do well in rallying with skills like that. Top draw drifting, I reckon.
There you go. Without careful enough for you.
In 400 yards, turn left.
I'm always careful.
It's full of home comforts, the EAT. Charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting. Even a portable espresso machine. Everything the intrepid explorer could ever
know. Right, let's see. Yeah, I don't care about that. No, I don't want a world map. Basically, just
turn around when it is safe to do so.
I don't want to turn around. Right, I've got a minute. See, Edinburgh is deceiving because it looks a lot smaller than it actually is.
Recalculating route.
Right, 4:33. Now I'll go round the roundabout and then I'll start. Oh, I didn't hit that tree. Game lies.
Turn around when it is safe to do so. At the roundabout, take the second exit.
Nah. I ain't getting 3 stars.
Alright, all this adventure kit's had a tiny effect on the fuel efficiency. Good job the roof rack holds 2 cans of diesel, and there's another one in the back. Just don't confuse them with your drinking water.
Exit.
On to the final stretch now. Just the small matter of getting up Arthur's seat. The clock's ticking, so better step on it, Stiggy.
In 200 yards, turn left. Recalculating route. In 100 yards, turn left.
And there we go.
2 stars.
Arthur's seat. No idea who Arthur is, by the way, or why his seat's so big. Nice view, though. Shame there's no time to stick around.
That was close. Cheers, Jacob. See what other. That's going to put me back in the same chapter again. Evening, ST, how are we doing?
Now, I said we'd be driving some British classics, and you don't get more British than a car built in Birmingham designed by a man from Greece. Anyway, here it is, an original Mini Cooper S, an icon of 60s engineering. It was designed for cities, but this is the wide-body one, so we're going to need a bit more room.
and I know just the place. Ready, Stig?
Yes, I'm ready.
The Mini is cleverly packaged, capable of carrying four people and their luggage. Hand luggage, presumably.
Yes, I remember Dooms. I hope we feel like the tyres on this should have exploded by now.
The Cooper S was the car to beat on the famous Monte Carlo rally. It pretty much wiped the floor with the competition. Was developed by a bloke called John Cooper, who also built F1 cars, so it had real racing pedigree.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Hey.
Recalculating route. Turn around when it is safe to do so.
And it wasn't just Monte Carlo either. The British Saloon Car Championship, the Thousand Lakes Rally, even the Australian Touring Car Championship. Almost any time the Mini turned up,
turn left. Turn around when it is safe to do so.
And here we are. Told you it was spacious.
Yeah, it doesn't handle too bad off-road, I suppose.
We've got
right, a straight line
here,
and then turn
field,
right.
The original rapid runabout and the stick. I'm looking
I'll
forward to
that.
This.
Hopefully.
Look at that, laying down some rubber there. Not that it has much to lay. After all, tiny wheels mean tiny tyres. Now that's just showing off. What is it with minis and shipping containers?
There we go.
They sold nearly 5.5 million minis. But only this one could fly, apparently.
How's SC doing tonight?
Punches well above its weight. It's literally unstoppable. Forget rallying. This thing was made for demolition derbies.
Sorry, I'm not talking, but I'm concentrating on trying to keep the mortal fire nice and high.
Alright, someone tell the Stig we're done now. It's time for a spot of sightseeing.
I don't know what 3 stars was, man. Close. Close but no cigar. Come on, please say that's put me up to level 7. Please. Press applause. For return on top. No. Ugh. I can't thunder them all. Silo. Let's see what this gives me, shall we? If it puts me back on the beaver stuff, that Merc, then we can just jog on.
This is Project EAT. That's EAT for E-Class All Terrain. It's a modified Merc built by the Top Gear magazine team for finding bears in the woods. Not many.
But basically,
bears
you've got three stars on everything.
Still, there's definitely some terrain, lots of it. All you need is a good sense of direction, or not. Here's
that
Dig again,
sucks.
Looking lost. Terrified of maps, apparently. Inner compass points directly south. The EAT has a silky smooth V6 diesel. It'll do
155 miles an hour
on the road,
four times
but where we're going, we won't need roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rannoch by any means necessary and against the clock, naturally. But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres.
In 400 yards,
go straight.
Turn left. Recalculating route.
Well, it is a Mercedes wagon, so it's tough. And if you really want to smash stuff up, there's even a pickaxe in the back. Who says you need an SUV to go off-road? The EAT has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps and everyday obstacles. Ancient burial mounds, for example.
It's a shame you can't level trees, isn't it? I'll take out the trees. Oh, this is just painful now.
Turn around when it is safe to do so. In 100 yards, turn right.
That's some proper hang time. Actual air suspension.
Yeah, it sounds like the eldest still won't go to sleep.
It also has 340 horsepower, more torque than a cruise ship, and gets to 60 miles an hour in just over 5 seconds.
BRB.
Now it's time to head way over
there. Way over there? Yeah, I know. BRB, we've got it. 2 seconds.
But gravity pulls you straight down.
I is back.
There, to the very top of Arthur's seat. But first, what goes up?
Very, 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 very angry and annoyed.
In 400 yards.
400 yards drift, yeah, okay, we are.
That's a four-wheel drive car on mud tyres, completely sideways. You'd do well in rallying with skills like that. Top draw drifting, I reckon.
It's the first time I've hit this house. So that's new. Excuse me, coming through.
It is safe to do so. In 400 yards, turn left.
400 yards, crash. Any other hints and tips, Jacob, apart from avoid Edinburgh? Which I'm probably driving straight towards. I don't know. It's not that road, it's not that road. I've got a rough idea where I'm going. Make it
it's
as you go along.
Home comforts, the EAT charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting, even a portable espresso machine. Everything the intrepid explorer could ever need.
£1 million in cash? Have you got that in it?
Oh, tree!
No worries, Jake.
In 400 yards, turn left.
Great. Kids are still mucking about. I'm going to finish this event and go and explode.
At the roundabout, take the first exit.
Whee! Boing, 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 boing.
All this adventure kit's had a tiny effect on the fuel efficiency. Good job the roof rack holds two cans of diesel, and there's another one in the back. Just don't confuse them with your drinking water.
It's one of them things though, ain't it, Jacob? Tractor there.
In 400 yards.
It's just a case of
left.
Going a million different routes and just fine. Tuning
turn
the house.
Left. Yards, turn right.
No idea if this is the right way, but hang on.
At the roundabout.
With the roundabout, I don't care. I'm going
to
try
the final
again.
Stretch now. Just the small matter of getting up Arthur's seat. The clock's ticking, so better step on it, Stiggy.
In 200 yards, turn left. Recalculating route.
Recalculate the route all you like.
In 100 yards, turn left.
Yeah, we'll let one see.
And there we go. The top of Arthur's seat. No idea who Arthur
even
is,
though we're
by
going
the
down.
Way, or why his seat's so big.
We've got to the top.
Nice view, though. Shame there's no time to stick around.
Now, have I got 2 stars before? Can't remember. I don't know. Must be the first time I've got 2 stars. Maybe not. I don't know. Can't tell. Well, I've had enough of doing that now. It's peeing me off. I actually won the first one. Me and the youngest did one of these the other day. We actually won it. No, we came 8th. I don't lie, we came 8th.
In 400 yards, turn right. Turn right.
I can hear the vein pulsing in your arse forehead. in VR and stuff again. And I've actually got headphones on, because I can play ears for a change. I normally only have one on. Yeah, Eliminator. Something different.
In 400 yards, turn sharp right.
I don't want to turn sharp right, but I want to go straight line.
In 100 yards, turn sharp left. You have arrived at your destination.
Alright, I'll see if the Eliminator works. It worked the other day when I did it on the Xbox. But then if the Eliminator works, why is nothing else working? As it should. It's a bit backwards, isn't it? I suppose, yeah, it's Xbox and PC, ain't it? Totally different, yeah. One time consoles are good. The one and only time consoles would be good, you know. I can see a daddy long legs. Let's see what this does, shall we? See if it goes. It's not there, why not? I don't mind.
Drivers are set! The Eliminator!
Oh, this is working. Surprisingly. Here we are, driving. This isn't actually that fast, is it? Don't race me. He is following me as well, isn't he? No, no, he's giving up. Oh, great. See if we can get a car out of here, shall we? Yeah, no, we're too good. Catch you later. Hope you have a good weekend as well, mate. I don't know what this is pointing towards, but I'm just going to follow it. Ah, back in the area. Yay! I'm safe. I still haven't found another car, right? This is not good. This is very not good. Still 31 drivers left. What's going on? Please say it's a decent car. Oh, come on. Oh, level 4 again. Ugh. Oops. Oh, he followed me. Come on. Mm-hmm. Oh great, I ain't racing a bugger. Definitely be out in 5 seconds flat now. My only hope is to stay away from everybody. And then hope and pray I can get to a car a lot better. Well, safe to say that it's not working. We'll just do more. No. Sorry, that stuff. Ooh, new house. Popping to this house yet? No, I don't think I have. Right here, let's just have a look at this one, shall we? See if this one's any fun.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
I need to turn around. Straight line.
Recalculating route.
Yeah, recalculating route. Okay. Ah.
It is safe to do so.
That's better. Wide open spaces.
In 400 yards, turn sharp right. In 200 yards, turn left. In 400 yards, turn right.
Chances of me getting that are slim to none. Doesn't mean I can give it a really good shot.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
So close. A little bit faster. One more try and then leave it alone.
In 400 yards. Turn left. Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Yeah. Skin of your teeth, but I got it.
In 400 yards, turn right.
Yay, me, happy, happy.
Turn right. You have arrived at your destination.
Alex wants to set up shop here doing custom upgrades. He's calling it Upgrade Heroes. And he needs a business partner who can really drive, but don't tell him I said that. You in?
Yeah,
I'll let Alex know. He's been waiting to hear if you wanted the business.
Why not? It's only 100 grand, we'll make it back soon enough, won't we?
Hey, great to see you. Look, I've got a bit of a business idea here. There's loads of cars around here that have real potential. I call them Upgrade Heroes.
Yeah,
you go
yeah,
get the
yeah,
car,
yeah, yeah.
We do the magic, then show everyone what an Upgrade Hero can do. Sounds good? Good. Uh-oh, and you get to drive the courtesy car.
Yeah, this is the courtesy car, is it?
You ready for this? We're going to teach the whole of Horizon that with a wee bit of an upgrade, any car can be a hero. Let's get to work.
In 400 yards, turn left.
Right, 400 yards, drive straight.
Turn left.
Actually,
200
sorry.
Yards, turn right.
Right, here's where we're supposed to make our very first pickup.
How
are you nervous? Me? I'm not nervous. The 510, not bad. Japanese engineering, European styling. Best of both worlds, really.
So I get to drive this shit, do I?
Got us a good one to start, a Datsun. A client says it was the first car they ever owned and they always dreamed of winning races in it. Or at least, you know, being able to overtake something. Bring it back, but try not to smash it up. Remember, it's not yours.
In 200 yards, turn left.
We'll drive sensible this time, shall we?
Turn left.
It's not far to play, but
in
I don't
200
want to
yards,
ram it through walls.
Turn left. Turn left.
Turn left.
200 yards.
It's like king.
Turn right. Turn right.
I think we'll definitely do it within 2 minutes 30 seconds and no damage. I don't think I could for it.
Is it kind of poor? Rumble's a kind of poor. Yes, I am.
Excellent. I'll get the team to work.
I don't get free sauce for that. There's something wrong.
It's ready. You ready? Oh, I'm ready. Ta-da! What do you think? We've gone lower, wider, faster. Twin turbo inline six under the hood producing 337 horsepower. Oh, and there's that nonsense we strapped to the front too.
Time to show it off. How about you take it into Edinburgh? And feel free to, you know, open it up on the way.
Yeah, this is a normal car.
Listen to that! Never heard a Datsun sound like that, have you?
In 400 yards, turn left.
Whee!
In 400 yards, turn left. Turn left. Turn around when it is safe to do so. Recalculating route.
I don't know if this straight line isn't faster.
We're under specific instructions to be as loud and fast and conspicuous as possible as we go through the city. I think our client might have friends here.
It is definitely quiet tonight, Jacob.
Fantastic.
Never
Did you have fun? Well, no. If we got your blood pumping, then I'm sure the client will be over the moon. I have a feeling we won't need to wait too long for another one.
Ugh, one star. Continue. See what other. Ooh, doing it. So what other cars we'll get, shall we? Yay! Another 20 game points. Next chapter. Yeah.
Oh, again? Remember when I said we'd have clients lining up in no time? Well, we've got clients lining up.
So it's go time.
The client is an old Audi to just putter around town in, but they've always wanted to go off-road. This is one after my own heart. Let's help him out.
Cat.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Cat's trying to catch the pug.
Recalculating route.
Yeah, recalculate all you want. That's right. Okay, back of 30 car.
In 400 yards, turn right. In 200 yards, you will arrive at your destination.
Oh, three.
Right, wait there. It'll be along in a minute.
Can't do that on the way back, but kind of.
It's a Sport Quattro. An 83, I think. See, they stripped all the fun stuff out and sold a few of them as production cars, which is where this one must have come from. So it turns out the client doesn't just want to go off-road. They want to go off-road, Group B style.
Yes.
Well, off we go. Don't crash it on the way back.
No, we won't crash it on the way back. We'll stick to the road and we'll avoid blah blah blah. Blah blah blah.
Cheers. The team can't wait. This thing was built for Group B rallying, which, as we know, was completely mad. But hey, we like mad.
Oh, I wouldn't mind having a Group B rally car. You'd have to have the world's strongest roll cage.
You want to see it? No. It's got the trademark four-wheel drive system, which should help you handle the dirt. And we've bumped it up to 800 brake horsepower, which might not help, but... Oh. Blimey, it'll be good fun.
I've laid in a rally route for you. I tried to convince a client to sit in his co-driver, but they were a bit too scared.
Yeah, why do I want to sit in this for a long drive? Oh, I want this car.
Carload of hell-destroying power you've got there.
I know this. It doesn't drift too good, does it? Those all wheels are like. Oh no, it does drift it. I'm not being very good at drifting.
Springs and dampers handle the downhill. Group B lives.
There we go. how Jake will get on with his new projects. Or he's still working on Teddington.
Couldn't be happier. Oh, one more thing. I'm putting all of these in the auto show with the specs and modifications listed for all to see. Be your own upgrade hero. Got a ring to it, don't you think?
Super bad. That's just pink. Pretty well spent still, I got this one. Z4. What else? Yeah, need a hat. They really could give you some. I think I've already got a sprite back here. I'll drive down. It's more fun driving.
Turn right.
That's more fun to drive. Who's still watching? Nobody? Nobody? Anybody? Or am I just being background noise or something? I think until they get the service sorted out, there won't be any more Forza. Not quite as fun as a single player, is it? I
it is safe to do so.
Guarantee I'm going to regret this. Oh. Probably going to regret this now, aren't I? There we go. Feel a bit wide, but hey-ho. I'm still in the running. So no GPP out of the way, I'm sure they might mind. Excuse me, coming through. Peace. What over? Where the runners?
They're right behind me.
Oh no. What in the world will I do? I don't know, I'm gonna slice some of them down at least. Gotta catch up with them again now. Oh, no. Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong. Oh, back on track. There we go. Track, road, same thing. Come back here, Mr. Lamborghini. Why have they got the cars? Ha! You ain't going past. Me first. Jacob, how dare you? Gaining. We're gaining on them. Now we just need to overtake them. And get a massive lead. Okay. Excuse me, coming through. No! Why? I finish 12th, I'll have to pull this video because my language will be atrocious. If it wasn't live streamed, I could bleep it all out, but... Come on, excuse me. Not as fast as me, my ski, we get out of the way. No. Scuba. Oh, I was going to say, I missed it again, isn't it? Yeah! Poo 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 poo! I don't want to play no more! Should have put rewind on. Rewind. Gonna grab this bolt selector. Have it. Yay! I've done it, Ma. Look, Ma, no hands. Think I'm gonna come 11th, don't you? Well, it's not looking good when they get in first. Oh, go away. Love you, Iris, go away. Think I'm gonna finish this race and then call it a night. Unless by some miracle I can overtake the entire field. Lost 17% of the race, which I don't think is going to happen. Especially driving like that. Evening fast, yeah, not bad. Doing very sucky tonight. Tonight is not my night. I hope you're all well. Yay, I missed it! Woohoo! Kiss my ass. Yay, I lost. It was nice and cool here today, for
hey,
a change.
Don't sweat it. Catch your breath, get your head straight, you can run it again.
Oh, dear. Dear me. Semi-decent mountain. Yay, level 176. Woohoo! Yay me! Give me some money. That'll be. Dum 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 dum. That's what I was maybe doing, ain't it? I thought I was going to go down to... here, if I wanted to look at my new car.
When it is safe to do so.
We'll go down here.
Destination.
Pressing the wrong button Let's have a look at the rarest car, shall we? 2 million. Somebody that ugly cars. A Bugatti. What on earth is that monstrosity? Let's see if there's any Bugatti showing. Bayron 2.2. EB. Doesn't look like there's any Devos. Any quattros to buy? $18,000, is that it? Oh, I want to look in my garage to see what I've actually got. I can't remember. don't know, World Class Wrestling. Slightly different here. I did see a car that was silly money somewhere. I see her across for us. Got a load of cars I've just never driven now. It's hard keeping track of cars that I've driven and cars that I haven't. I've got a super fan. Oh, go on, let's jump in this, shall we? Shall we pimp our tractor? Supra? What's a Supra? I'm assuming I said Toyota in it. No, I haven't used my Supra. Sorry. That's what we want to do to our. I've got no idea what our feet is. Not exactly. Not exactly a fast car, is it? The tractor. There you go, I've used it. Happy now? See, I'll even take it outside. Forza Supra, yeah, slow. No worries, fast. Catch you later, mate. Oh, I think I'm going to call it a night here as well. It's almost 11. Excuse me. Doesn't drift very well. Park it just there. Alright. Yes. I think that'll that'll do us for tonight, shan't it? Dear me. Apologies, it hasn't been a very entertaining stream, shall we say. Well, I hope you've been entertained. I feel like it's been a bit of a letdown, but that's just me. Monday we will be back on Western Shore. Cracking on with a bit more of that. So hopefully you can make it for that. Hope everybody has a good weekend. And I shall catch you all later. Night, Jacob. Thanks for watching, guys.